Good morning, children. Okay, so let's start with taxation. Yesterday, I gave just a small introduction. Again, from the beginning, we can start, because if you are not able to understand the concepts, everything will go wrong. Anila Mohanan, ready? Shall we start with taxation? You need simple addition, multiplication, and percentage calculation of percentage discount. That's all only we need. Someone enter. Okay, children, I'll repeat it again. Listen, all of you. So taxation, we know tax. Okay, government collects various types of tax, and the tax is used for the social services like security, provision of salaries to the employees, and so on. Okay, there are two types of tax. What are the two types of tax? What are the two types of tax?
Direct and indirect.
Direct and indirect tax. Direct tax and indirect tax. So, indirect tax means it is a tax which affects a person or a group of person indirectly, is called an indirect tax. Okay? So, direct tax means it is income tax individually. If you pay it individually, it is called direct tax. Income tax, property tax, gift tax, etc. Direct tax. So here, this year we are going to learn only about indirect tax. We are going to learn about GST, and direct tax we are going to learn about income tax. These two types of taxes we are going to learn. Okay, so what is GST? What is GST? Goods services tax. Goods services tax. Okay, dealer means a person who buys goods or services for resale is known as a dealer. Is it clear, children? Okay, that term you should note it. Dealer means he will be buying it from one shop. He will be buying from the wholesale, and then he will be selling it. So he buys goods or services for resale is known as a dealer. Intrastate sales. What is meant by intrastate sales? Intrastates. So within the same state is called intrastate sales. And interstate sales means sales of goods and services outside the state are called interstate sales. Next term is output GST and input GST. Can you tell me what is output GST and input GST? Output and input.
GST.
Yes.
The GST. Paid by the dealer is called as input GST, and the output GST means GST collected from the customer.
GST collected from the customer is called the output GST. Okay, why? Okay, what is meant by input? Input means we are getting something, isn't it? Although he is paying that GST, he will be getting it from the customer back. Okay. Okay, so input GST and output GST. GST is paid by dealers on purchase of goods and services and collected from the customer on sales of goods and services. So GST, first the dealer will pay the GST, isn't it? So that one we call it as input GST, and the GST collected from the customer is called the output GST. Then types of taxes under GST. There are three types you will get. First one is CGST, Central Government Services Tax. Next is SGST, or if it is not a state union territory, means we call it as UTGST. Okay, if it is an intrastate sales, that is on goods or services within the same state, in intrastate sales GST is divided equally among the state and the central governments. Okay, if it is an intrastate, within the state means GST, it will be divided into two equal parts. So if it is the GST rate is given 12%, means 6% will be for CGST and 6% for the SGST. So thus, if a dealer collects 12% of rupees 3000, 360 as GST, half of which goes to the central government and half will go to the state government. Now what about IGST? IGST means integrated, okay, IGST, integrated goods and services tax. It is also levied on the import of goods and services into India and on export of goods and services outside. IGST goes to the central government. Okay, it goes to central government. So if it is an interstate, for example, okay, if a person buys something from Madhya Pradesh and sells in Punjab, okay, in that case, if the GST is 18%, the whole of tax collected, 18% of 5000, the whole amount will be paid as IGST, and the IGST will go to the central government. Okay, GST rates and all for common daily essential things and all, it is 0%, common use items 5%, standard rate it is 12%, maximum goods and all services standard rate it is 18%, luxury and sin items it is 28%. Okay, while calculating problems in everything will be given. Only thing is you should know what is GST, CGST and all, intrastate, interstate, output GST, input GST. All these terms, if you are familiar, we can start with the problem. Okay, you know about this credit, isn't it? Accountancy students, you know what about credit, okay? Objectives of GST, what is given? It harmonizes tax administration between the center and state, which will improve the ease of doing business. GST has an e-compliance mechanism, so each taxpayer registered under GST will be returning GST return electronically for every transaction and will match with input GST credit against output GST, and net GST will reduce tax evasion. Okay, these are, okay, it is transparent, that is the thing, it becomes transparent, what are the inputs and what are the outputs, everything will be known to them. Shubham, okay. So now let's do the next problem. Next problem, yesterday we did, just let's go through it once again so that we can start doing the next question. A manufacturer sells a washing machine from a dealer B for rupees 12,500. The dealer B sells it to a customer for a profit of rupees 1,500. So profit is given and this is the cost price, and in lower classes we have learned some formulas, children. What is the cost price, selling price? Selling price will be same as if profit is given. If profit is given, what is the selling price? Kartik?
Cost price plus profit.
Cost price plus profit is the selling price. If there is loss, if loss is there, means cost price will be more, isn't it? Selling price will be less. So in that case, what is the selling price? Cost price?
Cost price minus loss.
Minus loss. Cost price minus loss. Okay? Then suppose a discount is given, what will be the selling price? Suppose discount is given. Okay, all these terms we are familiar, we have learned this in lower classes, anyhow, just recall it. Suppose a discount is given, okay, in that case we denote this as marked price. Okay, so marked price minus discount. Marked price means some, okay, in that item some amount will be marked, discount will give the selling price. Marked price minus discount. Okay, discount means we have to reduce that much amount, isn't it? Okay, now let's go through that problem again. Now look at here, the manufacturer sells a washing machine to a dealer 12,500, and the seller B sells it to a consumer at a profit of rupees 1,500. if the sales are intrastate, listen children, if it is not mentioned, if it is given, it is okay. If it is not given, then we have to take the business as the intrastate. The sales will be always intrastate. If it is interstate, it will be given. Is it clear? If nothing is mentioned, means it is intrastate. So, if the sales are intrastate and the rate of GST is 12%, find the amount of tax paid by the dealer to the central government. Amount paid by the dealer to the central government. Okay. So, what the dealer do? What the dealer is doing? Initially, he is buying this much for ₹12,500. While purchasing that one, he will be paying the GST. And what is the GST rate given here? It is 12%. So, it is intrastate. So, CGST will be 6% of the cost price. So, 6 by 100 of 12,500, it is 750. Similarly, the same amount only, it will be equally divided. So, SGST will be also 750. So, amount of input GST, what is meant by input GST? Amount paid by the dealer. Amount paid by the dealer for GST is, input CGST is 750, input SGST is 750. So, the manufacturer A will pay rupees 750 as CGST and 750 as SGST. So, the manufacturer will be also paying the same amount. Is it clear, children? Okay. The manufacturer will pay rupees 750 as the CGST and 750 as SGST. Now, since the dealer B sells the washing machine to the consumer at a profit of rupees 5,500, the selling price or the cost price of the machine for the consumer, consumer will be paying GST on his cost price. So, what is the cost price for the consumer? Cost price of the consumer is 12,500 plus this profit. So, this is the cost price. And what is the percent rate given here? 12%. So, the consumer will be paying CGST and SGST. So, SGST will be 6% of, so 840, SGST is also 840. So, what is the output GST of the dealer B? Output GST of dealer B is, output CGST is 840, output SGST is 840. So, what is the amount of tax paid by the dealer B to the central government? Okay, note down this, amount paid by the dealer is output CGST minus input CGST. This is the formula. Amount paid by the dealer to the CGST will be output CGST minus input CGST, that is rupees 90. The same amount only will be paid as SGST. So, that is again amount of SGST paid by the dealer is. So, what is the amount of tax received by the state government? So, the state government will be receiving the amount from the wholesaler as well as from the dealer. Is that enough? So, the wholesaler is paying rupees 750 and the dealer will be paying rupees 890. So, we will get 840. Now, look at the next question, next part. The amount which the consumer pays for the machine is cost price plus CGST plus SGST. So, 1400 plus 840 plus 840, you will get 15,680. This is how we calculate the CGST and SGST and all. Is it okay? Yesterday we did the question. Is it clear? Is it okay? Just revising it, because the next question and all are similar questions. You have to practice such questions. Is it okay? Anila, Mohanan, any doubt? Anila? Annette?
No.
Annette, shall we proceed? Start with the next one? Shall we write the, start with the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Write the question. Okay, write the question. A shopkeeper buys an article. A shopkeeper buys an article whose printed price is A shopkeeper buys an article whose printed price is rupees 4000 from a wholesale dealer. From the wholesale dealer at a discount of from a wholesale dealer at a discount of 10%. The print third question. One second, children. Third question now. Okay, first one is over. Okay, second one we didn't do, isn't it? A shopkeeper buys an article whose printed price is rupees 4000 from a wholesaler at a discount of 20% and sells it to a consumer at the printed price. He sells it printed price, otherwise we call it as marked price. Okay, note down all these terms. He sells it to a consumer at the printed price. If the sales are intrastate, and the rate of GST is 12%, find first one, okay, it is not in the screen, I'll dictate it. Find first one, the price of the article inclusive of GST. The price of the article inclusive of GST, at which the shopkeeper bought it. Okay, first one, the price of the article inclusive of GST at which the shopkeeper bought it. Second one, the amount of tax under GST, paid by the shopkeeper to the state government. Amount of tax paid by the shopkeeper to the state government. Next one. Third one. The amount of tax received by the central government. And fourth one, the amount which the consumer pays for the article.
Can you show the question once again?
The first part?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Hope you all copied this question. Karthik? Anet?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, children. Once again, read the question. A shopkeeper buys an article whose printed price is rupees 4000 from a wholesaler at a discount of 20% and sells it to a consumer at the printed price. If the sales are intrastate and the rate of GST is 12%, find first one the price of the article inclusive of GST at which the shopkeeper bought it. Second one, the amount of tax paid by the shopkeeper to the state government. Third one, the amount of tax received by the central government. Fourth one, the amount which the consumer pays for the article. Shall you do that one? Tell me, children. We are going to give the steps. So, what all the things given here? First, you write down all those things. What is given? A shopkeeper buys an article. So,
from price.
Yes. Price means, don't say it simply price. What is the price? Marked price, isn't it? What is the marked price given there? Printed price? Rupees 4000. It is 4000. Then, from the wholesaler, okay? From the wholesaler only he is due. Okay? From the wholesaler, the dealer is buying. Okay? And he, the dealer buys for a discount of rupees 20%. He gives a discount 20%. And what about the dealer? Dealer sells it to the consumer and he sells it to the consumer at the marked price itself. GST rate is given as 12%. We have to calculate all those things. So, first you start with the dealer. What will be the cost price here? What will be the cost price for the dealer? Discount is given as 20%. So, for the dealer, what is the cost price? For the cost price only we have to pay the GST. Okay? So, for the
300.
300. How?
800.
800. Discount is 800. So, what will be the cost price? Is it marked price minus discount? So, marked price is 4000 minus discount. How will you find? 20 by 100 of 4000. Okay, I hope you know all those things. Now, what is the cost price, Shubham?
3200.
3200. So, this is the cost price for the dealer. So, dealer will be paying the GST for this much amount, 3200. Okay. So, what is the GST percent given here? What is the GST percent given here? It is
12%.
And the sales is intrastate. So, half of that will be given for SGST and half will be given for CGST, isn't it? So, what will be CGST? CGST will be 6% of 3200, isn't it? It is for the dealer, It is 192. Children, are you able to calculate this one? So, SGST is also 192. SGST is also 192. So, now look at the question. What is asked in the first one? You want to find the price of the article. Inclusive of GST. Price of the article inclusive of GST by the shopkeeper. Paid by the
200 plus 192.
Is it one times he will pay 192? 3200 plus 192. Is it over, Aishwarya?
No, two times.
Two times we have tried because we have to pay the amount to the state government as well as to the central government. So, this is the amount paid by the shopkeeper.
3584.
Is it okay, Annette? Is it
clear, Annette? Yes, ma'am.
Now look at the second question, what is asked in the second one? Don't write. Now read the second one. Second one, what is given? The amount of tax
under GST paid by shopkeeper and paid to state government.
Amount of tax paid by the shopkeeper to the state government. So how much amount is paid by the shopkeeper to the state government? Can we say 192 rupees? What do you have? Is it 192, Karthik? Amount paid by the shopkeeper to the state government, or it may be central government. How will you do this? Amount paid by the shopkeeper, the middle person, how will you do that one? Output GST minus input. Okay, output minus input. So here, if it is asked by the shopkeeper, how much amount is paid by the shopkeeper to the CGST or SGST, means first we have to find what is the GST paid by the consumer. Okay, first we have to find the GST paid by the consumer. So we have to find what is the cost price of the, what is the cost price for the consumer. Do you understand, children? Chomlin?
Yes, ma'am.
Karthik, is it clear, Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so here the second question is the tax, amount of tax paid by the shopkeeper to the state government. Amount of tax paid by the shopkeeper to the state government means what you have to do? It will be same as outputs SGST minus inputs SGST. What will be output SGST? The GST collected from the consumer, only we call it as output GST. What is input GST? Amount paid by the shopkeeper to the wholesale dealer. That one we call it as input. So these two things, if you subtract, we will get the amount paid by the shopkeeper. Okay, so we want to find the GST paid by the consumer. So GST paid by the consumer means first we have to look at what is the cost price for the consumer. So what is the cost price for the consumer? What is given? Read the question again. A shopkeeper buys an article whose printed price is 4000 from a wholesale dealer at a discount of rupees 20% and sells it to a consumer at the printed price. So, for the consumer, what is the cost price? Cost price will be same as the printed price, isn't it? What is the printed price or marked price? It is rupees 4000. So he will be paying the GST for rupees 4000. So you find out what is the SGST and CGST paid by the consumer. Calculate it and find out the answer for this Roman letter 2. This is Roman letter 2. Amount of tax. Amount of tax paid by the shopkeeper to the state government. That means SGST. This one.
Then is it 480?
Which one? First one.
SGST is 240.
It is 240. So this is also 240. So amount of tax paid by the shopkeeper to the state government is. So it will be same as output SGST minus input SGST, isn't it? So, it is output SGST. It is 240. It is paid by the customer, isn't it? 240 minus, what is the first case? In first case, what is the SGST you got? It is rupees 192, isn't it? So, Aisharya, what is the answer you gave?
Is it 96?
240 minus 192.
Why don't we add the both SGST and CGST and then subtract?
Here, what is asked here? It is for the state government, so you take it for only the state. Okay,
yeah.
So output SGST minus input GST, SGST.
48.
48. Anet, is it okay, Anet? We are not adding both. If it is SGST is asked means to the state means you have to consider only the state governments. If it is central government means only that part you have to consider. It is 48. Now look at the third one. What is asked in the third one? The amount of tax received by the central government. What about the amount of tax received by the central government? Received by the central government. Find out what is the answer. What is the amount of tax received by the central government? What will be the answer? Anila Mohanan, can you give the answer? How much amount is received by the central government? Yes, children. Yes, Karthik. What is the answer, Karthik? How much amount is
624?
624. Have you got that 624?
The manufacturer should
yes.
give tax.
Hmm.
Shopkeeper and the customer.
Hmm.
So 192 plus 192 plus 240.
Once again, repeat it. What is your answer? 192
plus 192 plus 240.
Why 192 plus 192? Why you are adding 192 two times?
Manufacturer.
Okay, children, are you getting this? Chomlin, Anila Mohanan, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children, we can meet you in the next class. Okay, thank you.